Hey, welcome back into today's video. Trisha Paytas came out with a video exposing the vlog squad. Talked about David Dobrik, Jaosn Nash, and Brandon. You guys sent me requests to go through and break it down. And I've discovered some things that you're gonna wanna hear.
I'm just gonna put it all out on this video, and I'm starting with David, because even though Jason's creepy and disgusting, David's on a whole other level of being an actual horrible person.
Needless to say, Trisha broke up with Jaosn Nash after this video, but she goes into detail talking about the horrible things that David has done to her under the guise that they are just bits.
They say it's bits. That's how they justify saying stupid stuff and doing stupid stuff in David's vlogs. It's bits, but no, they're real people in real life, but they cover it up by saying it's a bit.
You know, it's interesting because it seems to me the mentality of it's the vlog life or everyday bro or this mentality of it's for the bit seems pretty problematic, as we've seen with Logan Paul and what it can do to him. It kind of seems like the same thing's happening to David Dobrik and the vlog squad, where they get caught up in this day-to-day grind. Hardworking, yeah, but why not just be yourself? Maybe because they're in this grind, they think they have to always one-up themselves, as I've heard it be said that our greatest enemy is ourselves. I think just do you, be yourself. People want to see the person how they really are. They don't care about all the extravagant things that you do. And Trisha has said how this made her feel and made it completely aware to David.
Said repeatedly to David, repeatedly, that I'm like, it's not a funny joke. It's not funny.
Trisha goes on to say that even after she told David how it made her feel, he proceeded to provoke her.
Like a couple vlogs ago, he's like, he didn't have a big bit for his vlog, and so we go over there and he's like, how bad do you want to help me? And then I got pissed at him that night, and I said, you know, not everything is for your freaking vlog. No, it's just a vlog.
After Trisha made this video, a lot of people reached out to me telling me that David's behavior towards people has become an issue, and especially against women, it seems like he's getting worse. She goes on to talk about the type of behavior that Jaosn Nash was exhibiting that led to her decision to leave.
Said like he tried to kiss Tana in a dressing room because they went on like a date for a vlog, him, Jaosn and Tana, and they both say that, you know, Jaosn tried to kiss her and she like pulled away, and he's like, oh, it was for the video, just talk about something for the video. Which I know Jaosn, and I had gone on a date with him for a vlog a couple months before, and he tried to kiss me, and obviously I reciprocated and we had sex, so I know if she would have reciprocated. I know Jaosn, I know him, so.
This is very concerning to me because the situation within itself sounds like sexual harassment under the guise that it's okay, it's just a bit. Trisha goes on to say that she's got no ill feelings towards Tana, and that Tana herself expressed disgust with the behavior of David and Jaosn.
And I don't blame Tana in any of this. Like, I have no ill feelings towards her. She's really cool to me. Like, she's always like, I just want to be your friend. I just want to hang out. Like, and so I don't think she, and she's always like repulsed by it. And so like, I have, this is nothing to do with her.
You can see by her emotions that this video is very difficult for her to make. She starts to go into detail on something that Jaosn and David did that sort of played into her insecurities. And my thing is, if they know that she's struggling with her mental health, why do they still expose her to this type of behavior?
It made the vlog of Jaosn saying, you know, he would buy David a Ferrari if he could get the threesome with Tana and me. And just like the whole thing, we've always talked about threesomes. I'm so insecure. I hate cheaters. I hate people cheating or wanting to cheat, or like, I'm not good enough. Like, I'm not good enough to, that like you have to go try it, you want to hook up with a 20-year-old, you know what I mean?
Regardless of it being a bit or not, regardless of the person or not, in general, this type of situation would hurt anyone. And it really just feels really disingenuous for David and Jaosn to be behaving this way. Trisha then goes on to say, and I am going to put this video in the description below so you guys can go through it. And speaking of situations that would make anyone feel uncomfortable, she goes on to actually expose Brandon from the vlog squad, saying this.
Brandon and their friend group was dating a high schooler last year. She was 17 years old. And when I would talk about this with, like, David, he would literally be like, oh, see, it's a big deal. He's 24. Like, she's 17. Like, you know, just because it's the law. Like, a year, like, 6 months. In 6 months, she'll be 18. I'm like, it's disgusting. Like, people have found this out. And, like, Brandon will call David and be like, oh, like, you gotta delete these comments about her age and stuff like that, because she was in high school when they started, like, dating and hooking up. Like,
this is wrong on a lot of different levels. If this is true, if these allegations are true, then what this means is that David Dobrik, Jason Nash, and the rest of the vlog squad were complicit on the fact that Brandon was sleeping illegally with an underage girl. Trisha has deleted her video, but this allegation requires evidence. So I went to looking, and I found some things that you're gonna wanna see. February 23rd of 2018, David Dobrik released a vlog where he tagged along with Brandon going on a date with the alleged underage girl, to which he said this.
Been seeing this girl for a month?
Around a month, yeah.
Do you love her?
Fuck off. Her name's Lacey. She's 18, 19.
You're like, I hope.
Now, don't you think that that's something that you'd wanna know for sure before you started a relationship with this person? That's when I found this pic. This is a picture of, her name is Lacey, celebrating her birthday. As you can see, the date is March 1st, 2016. Here's another picture on another March 1st of 2016 where she is celebrating her sweet 16. And you can see this is 2016, celebrating her sweet 16. So if she was 16 in 2016, that means when David released his vlog of 2018, that puts her at 2018, that puts her at 17 years old during this vlog. Now, what's so concerning about this is...
Is Brandon good at sex?
Honestly, yeah. Like,
hell yeah, Brandon, what's up?
I'm not gonna...
So at this time, Brandon is about 24 years old and Lacey is 17 years old. He knew what he was doing was wrong. David knew what he was doing was wrong. It was in fact complicit from what Trisha said from this now deleted tweet. February 2nd of 2019, Brandon says, I just wanted to clear some comments that were made regarding me today and some assumptions that I've been getting for a while now. My girlfriend is currently 18 and we started dating when she was 18. She's about to turn 19. To be clear, we never dated when she was 17. Please be mindful of how hurtful and damaging your words can be. Thank you. One Twitter user says her birthday is March and the video was filmed in February. Nice try. What's crazy is this was looked into after Trisha Paytas' video coming out exposing Brandon of this, exposing David of being complicit with this. And you can see why this is so concerning with creators that have such a massive platform. Now, these allegations are very serious, so we need to make sure. So I dug around and I found in a podcast where Brandon says this.
I'm going to start this off by saying I've been seeing somebody for about 2 months or 3 months, I think.
Do I know about this, bro?
You have no idea who this is. And I don't think anyone does.
But we do know who this is. Now, I want to note out at the beginning of this video, it says, the following video was recorded April 11th of 2018 for my podcast. And we've already confirmed from pictures that Lacey was, in fact, 17 years of age during these events. This podcast further exposes the truth that this is the case. But another thing is, he goes on to say,
just this overwhelming, we are also high, remember this, but it was overwhelmingly emotional. It was like it was pitch black and I was just feel like we were just making love. Like, that's what it felt like. It was
so, now knowing and understanding that this isn't a girl that was underage is a little bit concerning. I'm going to also put this podcast in the description below for you guys as well. Now, if you haven't been keeping up, what's essentially happened here is Trisha has put out a video that she's now deleted that exposes Jason Nash for just being generally just ugly and David Dobrik for being very, very malicious and under the guise that it's just a bit. It also exposes Brandon of the blog squad for knowingly messing with an underage female. Also that Jason Nash, David Dobrik, and the rest of the vlog squad were complicit in this. It's very concerning, but those are the facts, and I really want to know what you guys think about this. I know this is pretty troubling, very concerning, and I know this is going to make a lot of people feel different. And I just want to know what you guys think about this, because as interesting as this is, there's always something that's more interesting to me. That's right, you guessed it. I want to know what you think. So we'll just go ahead and leave your creative and interesting responses in the comment box below. Thumbs up for this like. As always, brothers and sisters, I will see you in the next video. I mean, it's very concerning because it's more than just a bit to people. And if these people tell you, confront you and say, this type of behavior, this how you're making me feel is not okay, and then you proceed to do it, it null and voids the fact that it's just a vlog and a bit, it's not a funny joke, it's hurting people, and then being complicit with hurting minors and underage like that, and it's not right. It's definitely not right to promote this on YouTube. But I know that you're repping, you start ripping, you're gagging. How do you do that? All you gotta do is subscribe, notifications turn on, be in the comment section to every single video, because I'm gonna be there, Greg the Cat's gonna be there, and the rest of the Repswell community as well, and I expect to see you there too, because this channel loves you. I need some more coffee. That's definitely what I need.